Okay, so the middle of my belly button's in the middle of home plate, and then I just reach my right arm out, you're gonna see this almost the shoulder width of the corner. So if I put my glove in the middle of my body, I did a gator clap, my hand's either gonna run through my arm socket, or it's gonna finish right on my hand. So if my catcher here set up the inner third, and the glove width is the same width as my chest to my shoulder, and I finish with my glove in line, then he shouldn't have to move his glove outside of his shoulder or to that side of his belly button, ever. So if I throw a good pitch and it hits where he's holding his glove, and then he looks up after he catches it and sees me, and I'm still in line, he's gonna tell me good job.
So you finished with your glove in front of your belly button, but when you threw, your glove was actually off to the side, and then you moved it in front
of you. Moved it, okay. So that's, how far did I miss my target?
Probably about the same length that you've missed your belly button.
So you're saying that if my glove was here, my arm would have came through here.
But your glove was a little bit over there.
I was over here, and so that made you reach a little over there. So if I'd have just done this, okay. I'm trying to stay in my heels more.
Yeah.
So if I'm in my toes, then my glove's going to swing around the line that my leg naturally bends. And that's right in between my toe and my heel, which is right down the middle of the plate. So when I separate my hands in front of that line, I want my hands to get on the line so that when I flip it, my head will drive over my glove and then he won't have to move. Get to my toe side, that's gonna push my hands even further around, and then I'm gonna finish even further outside my body and he'll probably have to catch it further over there. So I'm gonna try to stay in line.
Got it. Good stuff.
And sometimes they'll start to tell them to lift their leg and to lift their heel to their butt, and that makes your hands swim. So now I'm gonna go heel to butt and see what happens.
Up and arm side.
Up and arm side. So my glove's over here, my head is turned. When you turn your head, your arm actually sinks back further. Then if your head was straight, your arm would be further out in front. So your head follows your glove. So my head followed my glove that way. And then instead of stopping on this line and going down, it just kept continuing and it turned my head, dragged my arm, I missed up and away. This time if I fix it with my knee lift, and you can see my shoes on that side of my knee, that puts me in my heels here, which makes my knee kick down and I get a straight line of direction. So I'm gonna go knee lift now. My head's still a little bit offline, but not terrible. Better direction from the last one. And also we have a hands high separator. Hands high separators makes your hands swim around like this. And this hand position makes me take my head with my glove. And now I'm on my rotational side, so then I might spin up. So I'll try one with the hands high and see what happens.
Up and arm side.
Up and arm side, I miss. Try it higher.
Even higher.
Mid sternum, but the hands are still going to separate.
Now we get
to that side. So my arm is running across my line of direction into my own hand, which isn't the straight line of direction that I needed. Your hands lower, make it lean to your heels. Hands low, take my head away from my glove this time, instead of head with glove. So hands are low, head away from glove. Right on my spot. So other resistance, we got scissored feet with the hands high. So now when I twist, I rotate, I fall towards third. Okay, so if we twist and dive towards our leg lift, that's really gonna make me swim back up and around. Really far off to the side. So if your feet are all the way together and you pick your leg up, you don't feel like going backwards. You're just gonna either go forward or you're gonna stay the same. Put your feet wider than your shoulders and it's hard to lift your knee, so you end up doing heel to butt, and heel to butt sends you forward. If we go sideways, and my feet are narrow, when I pick my leg back up, so it looks sideways to you guys, I go sideways, then I come back to center, narrow with my feet, I'm gonna go either too far forward, or what I'll do is I'll go sideways, and then I'll miss my heel side line of direction, and I'll drift this way. And if they go too fast forward, then the arm's gonna drag. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna step forward with my footwork, and then I'm gonna pull my heel back to center. Now I'm on my heel side. That's no different than coming set. Now when I pick up, I have to go backwards because there's spacing in my feet. I have to go backwards first. So feet can't be together, you can't wind up too close to each other to the side. So we're gonna step forward, and then clear our heel back to the other heel, and then we can wind up and throw. Three muscles speed your arm up, two slow it down, and now we're gonna block our chest, and then we're gonna only have one muscle speed it down, we're gonna blow the labrum out. Hands high, block my chest. I'm right above my socket. If you notice, my head is behind my glove. If my glove gets out of the way, my head will go over further, that makes it lower. And if my head's really far past my glove, it makes it even lower. So these guys will either spin offline or they'll block their chest and miss up. So as a hitter, Ant, what would you look for in this guy? Where am I going to throw this pitch?
Middle up.
Yep. So what are you going to do in your hitting stance to hit that pitch? You're going to get your back leg up, your head stays forward, so that you can get your back to stay flat on the top pitch. You wouldn't lean in or lean backwards, because then it would change your angle when you're hunting a high pitch.
And I know that if you go down, you guess right. So I'm not even looking down. If you're a hand side separator and you hit that spot three times in a row down, good for you.
It just won't happen three times
in a row. It's not going to happen, though.
It'll happen once.
It's not going to happen. So that's why I'm hunting up, because you're going to leave it up.
So if I'm a hand side separator, I charge forward and I spin up. My curveball's going to be way back here, and it's going to bloop up right into that spot. Or I'm going to hook it, because I'm dragging, and my arm drags, and if it does pop out early, but if it doesn't pop out early, it gets cut off really quick. So it's going to be down at its feet. So that's why he's going to hook middle up. Otherwise, it's going to come right up into this wheelhouse. He's going to stay fastball, off-speed timing, middle up. Where are you going to look for a pitch right here?
Down in the zone.
Down in the zone. So what would you do as a hitter?
Get my knee going down.
Go ahead, show me real quick.
If I see your hands are low, I know I got to get low too. So I'm taking my knee low to the ball. I'm not going to drop my back shoulder and try and get to it. I'm going to take my knee forward to him.
Got it, slow hand separation. So if you throw a two-seamer, a sinker, and your head gets past your glove, your hand actually starts to pronate. The only way to throw a sinker is to get your head past your glove. The only guys that get their head past their glove are guys that separate their hands below their belly button.
That one actually had some sink.
Had a little bit of sink to it. So you just leave your head behind your glove, and then don't flip your glove up until your head's going to get past your glove. Now, by the time that I flip it and throw it, my head will be past my glove. That'll get me my sink. So how do these guys get sink?
They don't.
They don't. So as a catcher, you can't call a lot of changeups and sinkers with guys that are hands high. And you probably need two curveballs for one strike because they're going to loop one around or hook one. Now, if I want to go middle away, but my hands are in front of the line of direction, then as I lean backwards, I want to sink my hands back to here, because then when I stretch out and then I flip it, that's right on the outside corner. Then when I match my body up with it, the hip and the glove are right on line. Now when my arm goes across to hit the hand, it's going to go middle to away. Lower away. Pretty consistent lower away. Up and into a righty, I'm just going to raise my chin up. When you raise your chin, it's hard to turn your ears, and when you have a flat head, your arm goes straight. And when you have a flat head, your glove sinks right underneath your body to throw the ball. So if I just stand like this and pick my chin up and throw it, there's up and into a righty. Now I want the ball to go down. If your head's level, it's very easy for your ears to turn, but once you turn your ears, your arm drags. So you put your chin down. What does it do to your arm? Get your arm way out in front and your fingers on top. So now I'm going to put my chin down and throw it. Now it's even lower. Lower, lower. Chin down. The man's going to set up based on me. So if he sees me like this and he wants a pitch to a righty to be on the corner, and he sets up right on the corner, where, yes, because the other pitch would go where, man?
If I set up right here, it was going to go right here.
It was going to miss over. So he's going to compensate for the pitcher. So now I can aim at his glove that's off the plate, and then it's going to drift back. And now it's on the plate for a strike. Thank you, catcher. Thank you for being a good catcher. Set up for success for your pitcher based on where they're separating their hands. So now we're going to go low hand separation. I want the corner. Now he's right on it, and it doesn't miss. So really, you're giving away your pitches if you separate anywhere else but right here. Let's say I face this way, but I'm going to throw away to you on the corner. As soon as I separate my hands, if my hands go to you, so will my head. Now let's just say I was offline and I missed my spot.
Hey, you swam. Stay online.
Stay online, online. The nose, the belly button, and the glove is online on release, and I was not there.
Good job.
He's going to pump me up when I nail my position, so he can know that I can remember that.
Yeah, very nice.
Yeah, pumped up. I want to do that again. So another position you'll see some hitters, the pitchers get in, they'll come set, and then they take their hands. And you take both sets of your hands, You start in the middle of your body and you just start moving both sets of hands on one side of your body, you actually feel the shoulder turn in. Top half of your body turns in and you lift your bottom half, it wants to equal itself out, so it's going to twist. So some of these pitchers will start with their hands way back here, and then as soon as they lift, they twist, and they start going down the mound, and then their hands are too stuck on the one side of their body, and this opens up late and swims, and this arm comes through, and it's hooking, because the arm goes around. I'm going to end up separating over here, and then I got to twist back to this line of direction, and then it just keeps going.
You're just guessing.
And then you're guessing across the line of direction. So I hold my hands back here, pick up. Some people will teach to get this glove to go like that. I just don't understand. It's either the belly button to the arm side or middle, or it's the hip to middle to away. So as soon as we take this away, and you see disconnect, then you see the head tilt. And then the arm sets way behind. So I'm not sure why we have the hands so far on one side of our body, when really they need to separate right here in the middle. So when your front half goes out equally, your backside turns through equally. And if we leave one go and one stay, or one go and one stay, then there's the disconnect. You don't feel in rhythm. You start leaning back, you will feel yourself start to separate. And once your head gets to this side of your hip and you flip your glove, you'll feel your arm want to turn over. Tip of my finger faces it, it flips. Now that my palm's straight up, my ears will stay straight. And I get the perfect drop.